Hello and welcome to ANSYS-Tutor. In this video, we will see what is wall shadow boundary and why it gets generated automatically. How you can plot the Nusselt number along the length of the rectangular pipe. Also, we will discuss how could you find the skin friction coefficient value. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for all new updates. But first, we would start with creation of geometry in ANSYS Design Modeler. Right-click on Geometry and select New Design Modeler Geometry. Change the default units to millimeter, as it is a small pipe geometry. Select the XY plane and click on Z to make the sketch normal to the screen. Switch to Sketching tab and go to Draw Panel. Then select the Rectangle option. Draw the rectangle with the first point at the origin. Provide dimensions to the sketch. In the Details view, put the dimension values. Click on Generate to complete the sketch creation process. Click on Extrude to convert this sketch to a 3D geometry. Select the sketch and click on Apply. In the Operation drop-down menu, select the Add Frozen option, so this body will not unite with any other body, which is to be created later. Enter the length of extrusion value. Click on Generate to create the 3D geometry. Select the Face Selection option. Select the top surface of the geometry. Click on Extrude to create a body from the geometry surface. Click on any vertical edge to select the extrusion direction. Click on the arrow mark to switch between directions. Enter the length of the extrusion. Click on Generate. The second part gets generated. Press the Control key, then select all the bodies. Right-click and make all into one part. Geometry is complete. Close the geometry and proceed for meshing. Open the meshing window. Create the default mesh first to check if there is any error in the creation of geometry. Then insert sizing option. Hold Control key and select all the required edges. Then click on Apply. Put the numbers of divisions. Change the mesh behavior to hard, so that it will suppress the default mesh settings. Right-click on Mesh and select Generate Mesh. You can increase the number of divisions for a finer mesh. Meshing completed. Now, we need to put name tag to the boundary surfaces in the domain. Select the face and name it as inlet. Similarly, name the outlet boundary. Select the bottom surface and name it as heater surface. Select the other walls of the solid domain and name these as the adiabatic wall. Similarly, select the outer walls of the fluid domain and names it as pipe wall. Turn off the mesh display and check the name selection. Make sure that one boundary surface should not be named more than once. Click on each name selection. The selected boundary surface will appear red color. Also, name the solid domain so that it would be easier for material assignment to these domains in Fluent Solver Setup. Right-click on Mesh and Update so that it will be linked with the solver. Close the meshing and proceed for CFD solver setup. Select the double precision and click on Start. Double precision will use 64 bits per floating point number, which will decrease the round-off errors. Check the loaded mesh in the solver. Make sure that the minimum volume should not be negative. Turn on the energy equation for heat transfer calculations. In the current case, the Reynolds number is around 1000, which is within the standard Reynolds number limit for laminar flow problem. Hence, let's select the laminar viscous model. Add the default water properties from the Fluent database. Click on Cell Zone Conditions. Assign the materials to the respective cell zones. Water to the fluid domain and aluminium to the solid domain. Go to Boundary Conditions. Arrange the boundaries as per their type. Select the inlet boundary and click on Edit. Put the required inlet velocity. Keep the default inlet temperature of the water. Keep the default pressure outlet boundary condition at the outlet. By selecting total pressure in the backflow pressure specification, the solver will prevent any of the inflow at the outlet boundary. To assign an adiabatic wall, we need to keep the heat flux as zero on that boundary. Enter the heat flux value on the heater surface. To recognize any boundary, you can enable the highlight zone option. Assign the coupled boundary condition to the interface wall and the wall shadow boundary. What is a shadow boundary wall? When there is a model with a two-sided wall zone, that means one side is solid and the other side is fluid. Then a shadow zone will automatically be created, so that each side of the wall is a distinct wall zone. The interface wall on the solid will form the shadow wall, and the interface of fluid zone will form the wall. Boundary condition assignment is complete. Click on the solution method. Keep the default coupled pressure velocity coupling scheme. Select the spatial discretization for gradients as green Gauss cell based for better accuracy. Click on the monitor, then decrease the residuals for energy as below 10 to the power minus 15. As energy will converge more rapidly than other equations. So decrease the residuals so it will take more iteration at the same time will increase the accuracy of the result. Decrease the residuals up to 10 to the power minus 6 for the other numerical equations. Click on the initialization. Select standard initialization. Select compute from all zones. Then click on initialize. Now, go to file menu and select data file quantities. In data file quantities, select the additional data files which are not available in the default setup process. These are to be saved in this simulation. Click on Run Calculations. Put the number of iterations to run and click on Calculate. The calculation gets completed. The solution gets converged at 427 iteration. Close the setup and proceed for CFD post-processing. In CFD post-processing window, we will now draw a chart of Nusselt number versus length. For this we need to insert a reference line along the length. Enter the coordinate of the line, it should touch the solid heater plate surface. The samples option will create that number of sample data points on the reference line. The reference line can be seen as in yellow color. Insert the chart. In the data series, select the line as the location. In the x-axis, select the z-length and in y-axis, select the surface Nusselt number. This is the Nusselt number variation along the length. To observe the skin friction coefficient variation along the length, select it in the y-axis data selection. Click on Export to save the data as Excel file format. With this, let's conclude this video demonstration. Please hit the like button if this video is helpful, comment below for any suggestion or feedback. Also, share this video with your friends if you find this video useful. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.